For our third property, we're staying in the surrounding area as we head to the lakeside village of Annenheim. It's a 10-minute drive from Villach's historic city centre, which sits on the River Drava, beneath the peaks of the Gailtal Alps. This medieval centre is a real cultural highlight of the region, hosting various carnivals and festivals throughout the year. Its pedestrianised centre also offers up a good selection of local shops, cafes and restaurants. Our property might only be 10 minutes from the city, but it couldn't feel further removed in its stunning, tranquil location.
Here we have it. Cracking on.
Okay.
House number 3 is next to this amazing lake, Oziaka Lake. The house I want to show you is this one.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Yeah. Do you like it?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. Do you like the style? Even
I
though
do.
It's a little bit wooden.
Yeah, but it's a lot different than the first one.
An exuding character.
It's got lots of character. Let's look.
The main part of the house was built in the late 1980s across a 2-year period. The exterior's mix of wood and render seems to be a happy compromise for John and Elaine, and I think they'll be blown away by the outlook as we make the climb to its elevated position.
It's all about this.
The view.
That is a fabulous view.
It's a goodie, isn't it?
Yeah.
And this is pretty much your garden.
Okay.
This is really where you'd be spending all your time. And you've got obviously access to the lake, swimming and water sports. And behind us here, well, literally the bottom of the cable car is down here, is a big ski resort.
Fantastic.
Really?
So 20 kilometres of skiing.
Really?
And you could walk to the ski lift.
That pushes my buttons.
Yeah. What are you thinking there about it?
I like it. I like the view. I love the way it's where it is. And the look of the house looks nice.
Let's look inside.
Now, I've had positive starts with these two before, but the interiors haven't added up. Let's hope Elaine gets a positive first impression as we enter in through the side conservatory.
So is this big space with these retractable doors.
Oh, this is nice.
This is beautiful.
And then into the main space. This is perhaps a slightly more snug room with the fireplace, and then he's built in this sort of like great big sort of seating area, again, to maximise the view.
Good feel.
Yeah.
Yes.
Job well done so far.
Good. Is it going to pass the kitchen test? Let's see. There's this dining area with this fabulous kachelofen, which you know by now, but perhaps the smallest of all our kitchens.
Mm. Ooh, that's equal.
It's interesting that Austrians and actually Germans too don't really like sort of like open plan kitchens. They think they smell.
I'm not quite as doomy about the small kitchens.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So what is it that's changed your tune?
The view.
Oh, it's the view.
No. Let's be honest about this. The ski lift.
You know him much better than me.
Absolutely.
I think that's what you call being totally rumbled. As with many Austrian houses, this property also has a huge basement with plenty of storage, as well as a utility room and workshop. But we're heading up to the first floor, which has a spacious bathroom with an enclosed shower. It also houses a sunbed, but that could also be removed to free up space for a bath. There are also two bedrooms, the first of which benefits from full-length doors, giving it a light and airy feel, whilst the second has to be my trump card.
Not going to get a lot more open plan than that.
No.
This is a nice space, really nice space.
The house only has two bedrooms.
Okay.
Largely because this one is so gigantic. And then a very big, nice sort of wooden-clad bathroom. Mm. With its own sauna.
Mm.
Oh, gosh.
And a little sort of... So it's a toilet that looks like a sauna, but it's actually a toilet. I mean, would two bedrooms work?
You could change something downstairs that if you need to accommodate more people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Would you like waking up here?
Yeah, I think I could live with that.
Could you, Elaine? That's the question.
I don't know.
What's the stumbling block?
Just the outside space of this, I think, one. I need another good look round outside.
Well, let's go outside and talk about money. Oh, here we are back out with the view.
Stunning.
So I think you probably rethink the way that you actually live because I think you would end up spending quite a lot of time out here.
Yes.
This would be your garden. How much do you think the house is worth?
I would say 365.
Yeah, we're on the same page. I just said 360.
This is on the market for 335.
Really?
That's fantastic value.
That surprised me, yeah. Because of its location and the views and what we've seen so far.
And, you know, just have a wander around and see whether you can make this work for you.
OK, will do.
Our third property comes in at £40,000 under John and Elaine's budget. It's a traditional Austrian village house with two bedrooms, an open-plan living space and a large cellar. While the house doesn't come with much outside space, it does offer up spectacular views and it's just a stone's throw away from a local ski area.
Well, this house definitely spins my wheel, floats my boat. It's open plan, it's compact, it's pretty low maintenance all around. The downstairs cellar has loads of scope for a spare room and a bathroom, making it from a 2 to a 3 bed. Everything's just fantastic.
I like the fact it's under budget, which would give us enough money to do a few alterations that I think it would need. My concern is just the access for when weather is bad. I need to know how isolated I am if we're under 3 foot of snow.
Finished?
Yes,
all done.
Thank you. Yes.
So this seems like it got more of a thumbs up than most.
Definitely. Yeah.
Good, well, keep that positive energy and let's have a rest.
Super, lead on.